Yep, maybe they've done their research secret. They were able to win when they had a Huskar. Not all the time, but
10
it was
seconds
there
remaining.
prevalent in all of the times they won this this group stage at TI6. So they're not gonna let
5
them have it.
seconds
Newbie
remaining.
realized that may be a strong point of
Newbie
secret.
is
Take it away.
down to
In
bat.
response, Team Secret removing the IO. Andy, what are you expecting from this series?
I mean, obviously, I'm expecting Secret to come in today motivated more than ever just to try to get some wins on the board.
Now,
I mean,
at
this stage, you're not necessarily saying for sure that you can still get top four, but there are a lot of teams who are really close together in terms of standings
Absolutely.
Here in Group B. And this is the first Group B game of the day. Newbie right now sitting at 5-5. Secret are 3-7. So if, for whatever reason, Newbie get 2-0'd right here by Secret, then Secret are pretty much right back in it.
They really are.
It's just by virtue of the rest of the group standings.
That's the thing. People have got to remember, because there are so many games in these group stages. It's, yes, you have lost, what, 6 yesterday in a row, but that isn't the majority of the games you're playing, and there is still a chance, as you said, to climb back up, especially when you look at the overall pitch and how close the groups are and how crazy they've been, how many upsets we've had, how many incredible matches of Dota we've had as well. And we go back to the draft. Newbie now with their second ban. Taking a bit of time here. I'm going to go straight in and are eating into the reserve time.
I mean, we've just seen so many different play styles so far in the group stages that it's really hard to put a finger on what each individual team is prioritizing the most in regards to who they're playing against. But we know for a fact that Team Secret had a really good run with Huskar, so for obvious reasons, Newbie want to take that out. Just don't give him the hero that they've had the best performance with. Probably one of the safest ways to go about it up until this point.
Yeah, this is obviously going to be a series as well today that a lot of people have their eyes on. Yesterday, we could see the man himself there, Envy. He didn't have too great of a time. There were certainly, times where he just didn't look at his best, because we've seen Envy at his finest, and yesterday just wasn't his day. So a lot of eyes on him to see if he's able to step up to the mark and raise his performance back up to where we have seen it be in the past historically. And a Team Secret can really bring it all together in this group stage when it counts the most.
I mean, they clearly have the players.
Yeah.
I think a lot of it has to do with the strategy, and maybe the drafting was a little bit off, but today, it's a new day. You sit down, you're like, all right, we're not going to make the same mistakes we did in the previous matches. Newbie are no pushover, though. And I mean, going into it, before the TI group stage started, I always looked at Newbie, Liquid, OG, Wings, these other teams as, top contenders. So I don't think that Secret are going to be given anything too easy here to get their games back on track. But look at the first pick. Probably one of the longer ban and first pick phases that we've seen so far in regards to what heroes they want to play. And we're going to see a little bit of a blast from the past. As I think right now it's been like 99 heroes banned and 98 heroes picked.
It's gone up because
Omni Knight was picked by Na'Vi in the last series.
We had, Outworld Devourer as well today.
Yep,
everything.
Picked that. Yep.
Everything has been coming out and absolutely remarkable as well. I'll be interested to see how many people actually are able to predict that, of course, correct in the compendiums, as we are already in the top upper bracket of a selection. The Secret, now with the first pick, we'll see what they decide to open up with against the SD from Newbie. See what kind of 1-2 they want to bring in today. And as I said, just referring to the performances yesterday, I'm going to be very interested to see what Puppy does put Envy and also Arteezy on in terms of cores, because it just wasn't coming together yesterday, and it feels like something new might have been tried. They need to kind of go back to the drawing board, look at what the strengths of these players are, and make sure that they're on the heroes that they're incredibly comfortable with.
I really liked the Morphling from Secret yesterday. I know that Artur played it. Granted, they didn't win the game, but I feel like it's something that fits very firmly into what Secret like to do. At some stages in the game, you get to that late 45 plus minutes and you can split up the map. You have this hero who's very difficult to kill, can get solo picks. It allows him to pretty much dictate the tempo of the game past like the 30 minute mark. Of course, we're not going to see that until a bit later because it is a core hero, but just something that I personally would like to see them running again. But this is a Team Secret special here. They're going to pick themselves up the Elder Titan. It's something that we've seen them run time and time again. The question is, do they want to go for the Void? I mean, Batrider's obviously taken out of the pool, so you don't necessarily have to worry about picking up your Oracle really early to make sure that you have some kind of counter towards that. But there's still a multitude of heroes you can partner this with.
Absolutely. It's a Puppy favorite and a hero as well that we saw yesterday in Secret Series, where they're able to hold on in a game where they're about a 35,000 net worth behind. They're able to lengthen it and keep fighting, all because of the Elder Titan, because of that aura, because of the way that you can hold the high ground and allow you to fight into an advance from the enemy. It really is one of those heroes that can just do so much, even when you're that far behind. and they'll pick up, of course, the Mirana as well in tandem. A combination that a lot of teams aren't letting, you know, opponents getting hold of, because, you know, you look at the ET, as we said, we're talking about the aura, a perfect hero to combine that with is the Mirana, of course. Getting that Aghanim's, getting that double Starstorm, it's an insane amount of damage with the spirit on top of a hero.
And not to mention, Elder Titan's a natural Veil Carrier, so you're amplifying that magical damage even more to some point if and when you get that farm, which I assume we're probably going to see. Because even, I think, even though Secret lost a lot of games, most of them at least went past 30 minutes. So you can say that Elder Titan is going to have this really, really strong influence during the time where Roshan starts to become more prevalent in the game, and you kind of need that Aegis to go high ground. That's when you're really looking at your Elder Titan to try to shine. So now Newbie, ball's in their court. Do they want to go for just picking their secondary support now? I mean, we've seen a lot of Ogre during this tournament. It's often been in response to that Elder Titan, but we will see the Timber. I like Timber. Obviously good against Elder Titan. The reactive armor is bonus armor, not affected by natural order in any way. The only thing about picking Timber into these types of heroes is that you typically want to go like Bloodstone and then into Hood. And we saw that build multiple times yesterday in the group stage, because you need some kind of protection against just the insane amount of burst that teams are picking in regards to magical DPS that doesn't also cost a fortune, because you don't really want to just buy BKB after Bloodstone. But yeah, well, I'm looking to see the Timber build, and hopefully he can get himself tanky and good to go for this match. But so far, both openings very strong. Secret probably a little bit more ambiguous in what they can do with their heroes with the Elder Titan and the Mirana. Whereas Newbie, you know they're looking for some other hero to partner with that Shadow Demon, and as I just say that, they take out the Luna, which does make all the sense in the world. Secret do have first pick out of the second ban phase, so if they want to leave themselves something else, Elder Titan Morph is a really strong combination, because you expect the other team probably doesn't pick Morphling because you have Elder Titan, and it also leaves it open for you a little bit later, and as I mentioned before, I do like that hero a lot when Secret run it.
Is there any reason for Newbie then in that sense to ban out the Morphling from Arteezy?
I mean, you can definitely do it. It just depends on what your priorities are. Because you see Elder Titan, Mirana, I mean, yeah, you assume that it's going to be support Elder Titan, and you probably assume at this point, you know, Artur has been playing a lot of Mirana for the team, so that's probably also running through the heads, you know, is it actually going to be a mid-hero? Is it only going to be the Artur that's playing it, or are they actually going to put it on a support, which I kind of doubt. I don't think Secret are that team right now.
I mean, we saw Envy Mirana yesterday, of course.
Yeah, we did. Yeah. We saw, but more often than not, it is Arteezy who plays it, so we'll see. Artemis ban is definitely a good thing, though. That hero is... That's like a Huskar tier hero to me right now. If you get it in the second phase and they don't have the right heroes to cope with the farming capabilities, or they can't pressure the lane, it's almost like, not necessarily an auto-win, but it does give you a huge leg up.
And it's very good as well for a team like Secret, especially with the ET, because this is a team that seems to have the tendency to find themselves in games that are going on and go to the later stage. If you've got an ET and an Alchemist holding the base, there's always going to be the chance for you to get back ahead and fight back incredibly hard. Team Secret and Response will take away the Naga from Newbie, make sure they themselves don't have that late game potential. 5 seconds. And that stalling passing, absolutely. Morph the Morphling that we talked about, Newbie, not going to let Secret slip that one through. As we saw yesterday, you know, Arteezy and Envy obviously can both perform very well on it. Arteezy yesterday had some games where he was able to just keep an insane amount of pressure on with the split push. And again, just making it incredibly hard for the opponents to close down the game.
And now the question is, what direction does Secret want to go for Arturus hero? Because I'm actually... With the Morphling ban, clearly Newbie are feeling that this is more likely a mid-Mirana, and yeah, okay, it will be the Void. We talked about that pairing as well when they opened up with the Elder Titan. I do think that this is probably one of the stronger teamfight compositions you can put together right now that don't also give you extremely weak lanes. So Mirana's alright in lane, maybe not the highest base damage, but can hold her own. Faceless Void actually has ridiculously good sets, and also it's very hard to ever force him out. I think it's a decent matchup against both of the heroes that Newbie have right now. And as long as you have some damage that you can throw on side of the Chrono, you're pretty much good to go. So now the Secret with the Elder Titan and the Mirana already, they don't have to necessarily focus on that aspect of the hero so much, and can maybe prepare themselves for maybe a bit of a stronger laning phase as Newbie do pick up the Nyx.
Yeah, I mean, the Nyx Assassin, that certainly seems to be a hero that we are seeing more and more of this TI6 group stage. And reasons why, Andy?
I think he's one of the heroes where if you get a decent lane, and you get like early 7, early Arcanes, you apply an insane amount of pressure. And most of the time nowadays, I feel at least in the TI group stage, the laning phase you know, it's very rare that you see somebody get crushed. You know what I mean? Like, somebody's just not getting anything. And that was the biggest problem that Nyx had, because he didn't really have as many places to go in the previous patches. And you couldn't really get away with running him, because you would just... like, first off, Iron Talon didn't exist. Not that we see it so much, but, you know, he just has more choices nowadays. And he's still a great mid-game hero, still a great late-game hero. It's just getting through the first, you know, 10 minutes or 15 minutes is what he always struggled with. But newbie... they're going for a... we've seen this tier a few times. I want to say this is at least the third time I've personally seen it picked so far. Very good in lane. Again, it's all about pressure. Following heroes around. You kind of act like an ogre to some degree. You just walk around and you just hit people with your zombie hands and just force some kind of reaction out of Secret up until this point. But I'm kind of curious how they're going to lane it right now, because I'm feeling like it's most likely going to be mid-Timber. And then Nyx is going to be played by KP. And if that's the case... I'm wondering what their core is going to be right now for newbie. What is their answer to the Razor Faceless Void?
Yeah, what are they going to pick maybe to utilize, obviously, the Shadow Demon's disruptions? Anything that's going to be able to benefit from the pushing power of the illusions?
I mean, honestly, Luna and Dro are the top tier.
They're the ones you first
opinion.
Think
yeah.
about.
And then,
yeah.
And then Terrorblade's also okay. But the problem with the Elder Titan response from Team Secret is Natural Order is unbelievably good against all the illusion heroes that you would want to pick, right? So they take out the Weaver, which is a house special for sure. Newbie have played that in the past. Heck, they played at lower bracket TI5 and he won. Or, no, sorry, that was Luna. But they do play a lot of Weaver. So a very, very good band there. And to be honest, they do have some lockdown for it, but only really one reliable spell, and that would have been Chrono. Otherwise, just too annoying, really strong laning hero, good mobility during the mid-late game.
Slot our ban, and indeed, this final pick
is it actually going to be support Morana? It's looking like it is right now.
At least, yeah, newbie
seems to assume that. Because they're banning Slardar, so they're thinking that it's actually going to be a support.
Okay. Well, newbie now. They need the carry. They need Howl's hero. I mean, I'm thinking about you. One of the heroes that we haven't seen that I do love Howl on is the Gyrocopter, but I feel that we're not at a point yet where we're going to be able to see the delights of a gyro again.
He's definitely the hero that it's really good fighting potential. That's the one thing that you can look to.
We will remember the age.
I mean, they could always
barrages.
Safe lane Timber and pick like something to go mid. Yeah, okay. So Juggernaut and Timbersaw are fairly interchangeable in this game.
Yeah,
probably both heroes just flat out lose to Razor. Like, no questions asked, because it's melee versus a Razor. You just can't win that lane. But we'll see which one they feel is the better matchup here. Even potential for Secret to go aggro in this game. Is this 4 melee right now on newbie?
I mean, yeah, that is going to be the thing. How Secret do want to lane this against newbie? A Secret final pick, and indeed, as we said, you know, there's still a bit of a possibility to switch around some of the roles and heroes. Batmirana throwing a bit of a spanner into the works, and as we can see, newbie are indeed assuming that it's more likely to be that support Mirana position. We'll see if that is going to be the case. A Secret will reveal their final part of their hand.
That Slardar would have been so nice if newbie didn't ban it. That hero would have been like perfect for their lineup. Remaining. Some kind of control would actually be great, because they... Yeah, okay, there's the control, the Beastmaster. How did that hero make it all the way through? It seems like, to some degree, Beastmaster... You see him either like first or second picked in some games, and then other games
just
he's
totally
ignored. And yeah, yeah. That's why this group stage is so unpredictable, because people just have so many different approaches of how they want to draft and the way they want to play these games out that it becomes increasingly difficult to keep track of. And as such, a lot of the teams are trying to find themselves here, Team Secret being one of them here in the group stage at TI6. But I'm looking forward to this game. I think it is going to be the KP Nyx, and it looks like we are going to be seeing the old mid Timbersaw.
Absolutely. I mean, the question is, Andy, we've seen a lot of Secret's draft yesterday, and I remember casting you, there were certainly some games, and I think other people did agree as well, where Secret did, you know, effectively come out with the upper hand in the draft, they just weren't able to execute it. Would you say here, Secret have a draft advantage, or a newbie in a very good position?
This one's really close, in my opinion. I think the laning phase is going to dictate a lot. So, newbie, if they can get KP some kind of good start, and the Nyx gets his early arcanes and gets his Vendetta going, I can very easily see a lot of pickoffs and just fighting around, having the Undying, the Timbersaw, the Nyx. Those heroes all are very good in terms of early game aggression. But if Secret get ahead in the lanes, and then the Beastmaster gets his Hawk going, you know, you get that early book, and you have Chrono for this teamfight potential and Moonlight Shadow, there's so many utilities that Secret have that they can use outside of the laning phase to force engagements in their favor. So it's 50, in my opinion, but the lanes are going to be super important for newbie here.
Well, I'll be able to see the lanes settle out as we get ourselves into this one, as DJ ladies and gentlemen at home can see us getting the heroes and the players on the screen, so you know who to follow and where the action is going to be going down. Puppy, of course, the captain himself. We'd imagine he would have had a talking to the team after yesterday and been able to build back up the spirits of Team Secret as they come into today's first game against Newbie. Of course, they will have to go on to play. I believe it's Liquid, isn't it? The other series they need to play today.
Yeah, not easy games.
No, absolutely not. It's not an easy day for Secret today. And of course, though, theoretically, can it be any worse than the day yesterday?
Yep.
I can.
I mean, if you want to word it that way, it can be as bad, but it can't be worse.
Well, we'll see the two runes. No one's going to contest each other at the moment. Timber to grab bottom, raise it. We had to grab himself top. And lane-wise, in terms of aggression, we are not going to see any aggressive tri-lanes coming out from either side. It's simply going to be Bulba on the bottom lane on Beastmaster, and top lane will be KP on the Nyx Assassin. So no one deciding to go aggressive against the farming cores. And do you like this decision? Do you feel that one side is going to get more out of the fact that a little bit of space is going to be given to the safe laner?
I think that Void's going to, the Beastmaster might be able to get a little bit more than the Nyx. Yep. Because Nyx isn't a natural Iron Talon carrier. Like, Sam has a backup plan in case his lane goes poorly, which is just go to the jungle and hit creeps. Whereas KP kind of needs to sit in lane and soak as much as he possibly can. So in that regard, I think that Secret are going to have a tiny bit of an advantage here. It just depends.
And this mid lane matchup, Moose Timber versus Envy's Razor. We did see there were a few games yesterday where Envy did struggle in the mid lane in terms of CS. Is he going to have a fine old time here against the Timbersaw?
I wouldn't assume so. This matchup is pretty hard for Timber. The best thing that he can do, which is what he's already done, he's skilled his Q and his W, so he's got the chain and the Whirling Death. He's not looking to really let the wave stay. He wants to push it in as hard as he can to make sure that Envy can't just freely link him every single time. And that's about all you can do. Eventually, the Razor's going to pull ahead, and outside of getting a gank, Mui's just going to have to sit here and get whatever he can get.
And in terms of rotations from the two teams' support, so are we going to see any attempts on the mid lane?
I mean, Arrow could actually kill Mu, but he needs to be harassed a little bit first. I think that's probably the most likely kill. Envy is a very hard kill on this lane.
Kaka, of course, at the moment on the Undying, has come up to the top lane to help out KP, put a bit of pressure onto Team Secret safe lane, tri lane. It's easy 6-4, and indeed, as we can see down on the bottom, 11-9, a much better time for the Jug, as Bulba has already started to head out into the side camp. So how indeed is going to get a lot more space in his lane compared to Arteezy's Faceless Void?
Yeah, the rotation of Kaka changes the dynamic of this lane pretty drastically, because the Morana is not really known for the right-click harassment during the early game, and this Undying, you know, he's already used a little bit of regen, but it should still be more than enough to keep Hao ahead of Arteezy for the time being. Just keep in mind that because he's playing Void and they have great synergy with the hero, that even if he's not CSing like perfectly in lane in comparison to the Juggernaut, he still has a multitude of follow-ups for his Chrono, and that's really what matters the most, I think, for them.
And this bottom lane, of course, I mean, how, as you said, in terms of combo, it's not necessarily there as much as Arteezy's Void with the setup, but how this Jug is going to get out of control with a start like this. And, I mean, at what point are we actually going to see Secret look to try and do something about the Juggernaut? Is it more just of a case, as you said, just trying to do something with Arteezy's Void?
It's more about the combos, I think, for Secret's team. And also, you do have an Elder Titan as well. And Juggernauts typically, you know, they build their Diffusals, the Mantas, the Scotties, all those items are stat-based, and they just get crushed by natural order. I mean, look at the game they played yesterday, 61 minutes, and Artur was playing Morphling that game as KP.
And top lane indeed. Oh, the arrow's going to be whiffed by Pi as KP's able to move just in time out of the way. The combo not quite there for Secret.
Super close. But yeah, as I was saying, it's more just about the fact that Elder Titan is just so good against any agility-based hero that, say, Hao has one full item on the Void. It doesn't matter if that item is like a butterfly or a Scotty or whatever, because the natural armor that you're getting from those items just is useless against Elder Titan. You're still super squishy. So the way they want to play is just aggression, you know, get that Nyx going.
Yeah.
Just fight around your Timbersaw during the mid game and just get whatever map control you can.
As we saw there in the mid lane still, Envy certainly holding the lead, 21-22 for 9, 12-0 on the Timber. I guess it kind of works both ways in the sense that Envy's going to have the damage to Siesta just sapping it from the Timber each and every time, but at the same time, Timber doesn't need the right click to find Siesta in the lane. So Moose's still going to be able to find something. You're never going to totally shut him down.
He's playing it very well. He understands the matchup, and getting doubled up is expected, honestly. Yeah. Like, sometimes you might even lose the lane worse than he's losing it right now, but also having the regeneration rune in his bottle is going to allow him to just pretty much stay here forever. Just a little bit of a quiet early laning phase here between both teams. About 5 minutes in, everyone's kind of just hitting their creeps.
And Bulba, it's going to be interesting to see how Bulba advances this game on the Beastmaster as well. Obviously one of his heroes that he's very comfortable with. He's rocking the Iron Talon. Level 3 at the moment. He keeps popping in and out of the lane. He hasn't entirely committed himself to the jungle. But we have indeed seen in games gone by how much a Beastmaster can do if he gets a lot of space at the start. Chuan, coming around behind the tower. Just going to have eyes on the boar. Team Bulba keeping himself back and safe. Puppy's actually heading over to this part of the map. The Elder Titan, so we'll see if they can do anything in response. Mid lane, Envy. Moving in, zoning, move back. Another easy 73 stolen damage. The Razor, Tao, and Chuan start to put a bit of pressure onto the tower with the help of Kaka. P and Bulba doing their best to hold things off here. There's no point in healing ward for Haon. I mean, I guess this is just down to the fact that in lane he hasn't needed it, as there's not been any heroes beating him down. But as we can see, without that point, it is going to slow in the side of newbie down when they do start to turn into a bit of a push.
He did opt for a point of stats, and I think that's just to ensure that he has enough mana to be able to use his ult and spin. But don't think he actually needs it anymore. With just the branch, I think you have enough. So
yeah,
maybe,
this stage you don't.
Maybe a bit of a miss skill, I'm not sure. It does help you in the early stage because Juggernaut's base damage isn't like amazing. He just has a good animation, so maybe he just felt more comfortable having the stats to out CS the Beastmaster. That's also something else, because if the support's pulling and he knows that Kaka's top and Bulba's in lane, having 1 point in the stats doesn't sound like a huge deal, but it can allow you to CS a little bit more effectively against a hero like Beast who has ridiculous base damage.
In terms of build-wise for how do you feel we're going to just see standard stuff, Battle Fury, Yasha, and then into the later game items? Is this a game where he needs to pick up such a demand to defusal against Secret's lineup?
For now, it looks like he is opting for the Battle Fury.
Yeah,
at the very least, he has the Ring of Health in his inventory. I don't know if we're going to be seeing that Vanguard build that, you know, prior to TI became a little bit more popular. Just, you would push behind it and just have this really tanky frontline jug. I don't think that works against Razor at all. So yeah, I'm thinking that it's most likely just going to be the good old BF build.
Oh, how again, once putting the pressure on. Tier 1 on the bottom lane, falling very low for Secret. Only Puppy at the moment down here, soaking up the XP. Bulba has now moved straight over to the real jungle of Secrets, so he's going to be able to continue to find some space there. Chuan and Kaka have smoked up with a movement. See how they want to wrap around Chuan. Actually just going to come across the river, maybe look and see if Arteezy gets a little bit aggressive onto KP. See if they get a chance of punishing it, but it's going to be hard. Arteezy, 3 points in the time walk and Chronosphere at the ready. It's a very hard kill for newbies. They don't have a huge amount of lockdown between these heroes. And it looks like Chuan and Kaka, yeah, as the smoke wears off, and with the ward that Puppy was able to place here earlier, Secret well aware of newbie's plans, and nothing's going to be found with this movement. And still 7.5 minutes in, no blood yet to be shed as both teams playing it very carefully.
The offlaners are about dead even in regards to overall farm and experience. Interesting part is KP actually has 100 more net worth than Bulba, which is just...
Ooh, Pi could be in trouble as moves come with a rotation. Pi gets the leap off. Newbie are going to look for the chase down. Tombstone drop. Moo cuts him in half.
Got him.
First blood for Newbie as Moo finds the successful rotation and is able to break the piece that we've had for the first 8 minutes.
Yeah, that damage with Soulcatcher and a Timber Saw is no joke. You just get blown up if you get caught by that. And it just, again, shows the aggressive potential of newbie's heroes. Didn't even have to land the stun, just killed the hero anyway.
Bulba on the bottom lane, just about to hit level 6. And it looks like Secret might want to do something with this. Pi and Arteezy coming down for the action. How would be a very big kill for Secret to pick up at this stage of the game. He's had pretty much perfect CS in lane. How all the space in the world, and well, they're going to look to lead in. Bulba with the roar. Artur jumps forward. He's going to drop the chrono. No messing around. They're not even going to need the arrow because Hao's already dead. And Secret able to pull off a nice clean kill on the bottom. on House Juggernaut, which is exactly what they were looking for, as they're now able to turn it into a push. Four of the heroes on Secret down on the bottom lane. There's going to be a TP in fact, from Mu. We'll see what they want to do about this. They're already moving in. More TPs coming in from Newbie. Mu has to be careful. Pi jumps forward. The Starstorm damage not quite enough to kill him, and Mu still alive. The defensive disruption from Chan, keeping Timbersaw fine, and Kaka drops the Tombstone. RTZ trying to take down the old Grave. He's time walks away. Newbie gonna be able to chase for anything more. Looks like Secret will be able to back off. So no one to fall, but Newbie able to stop the push from Secret.
Top lane as well.
KP with the first Vendetta strike onto Puppy. Puppy's been left alone. The rest of his team headed to the fight down bottom. Can't quite get himself out of the range of the Blade Fury. As Newbie ends up managing to play round Secret's play. They send resources down bottom, but they leave enough up top to find a kill and punish Puppy's loneliness.
The rotations from both teams are more or less on point. I recognize the fact that Secret more or less had a TP bottom, so they know that Puppy's vulnerable. Puppy's up there just trying to soak whatever experience he can, right? You want Earth Splitter as soon as humanly possible to partner with RTZ's Chronosphere, so it's like, okay, he's going to be greedy, so we can just go ahead and get this kill. And in that sense, they didn't get to kill Mu, which was a bit unfortunate. The disruption there from Chuan saved him. If that wasn't there, for sure would have been a dead Timbersaw, and maybe even the tower would have died just from that one trade alone. But now it's being sieged pretty heavily here. No reaction just yet from Newbie. A lot of people low on mana. Not sure they're gonna not TP for this. Just gonna let it die, I guess.
So that's gonna be the case. They're hanging around in base. Looks like the TPs are actually gonna come out towards the top lane. They're just gonna accept that they've lost the tier 1 bottom. RTZ takes a bit more gold into his pocket. With the TP top, KP looking to set up with the Vendetta. Pylite die. The lone man guarding this top lane. KP will get the wraparound. He's going to need a bit of backup. He does have Chuan coming in close. Pi, realizing trouble is afoot, trying to get himself away. The stun connects. Have the damage. The first bit of poison will come across. KP's going to need another touch, and that poison is going to do it. Chuan perfectly landing it from a mile off. As Newbie will get the kill and also find the tower up top.
That's really unfortunate for Pi. Like, he leaps because he wants to get into a better position, but not realizing that Nyx is right on top of him. Normally, if you knew the hero was there, you would never use leap like that. You would wait until you got stunned, and then you would leap away to ensure that you had made a bigger distance between you and the hero. But unfortunate circumstances, not having a sentry behind the tower. They get the tier 1, but Secret are pushing into a tier 2 right now, and they do have their ultimates available.
They do. They have everything ready for a fight if Newbie want to kick it off. They've smoked up Newbie, and they're going to make the movement across the map, see if they maybe can get a bit of a wraparound onto Secret. The Secret already, realizing the danger, could very well be on his way, and they'll just be content with dealing a significant amount of damage to the tier 2. Newbie still might find a chance to find a pick off KP, leading him with the Vendetta. Puppy starting to back off. Newbie just checking out the pit, making sure no one on Secret was hiding in there.
Careful.
Here we go, see how KP wants to start this one off. And he's already popped the old Moonlight out, the Roar onto Hao. And the Earth Split, the Chrono is going to catch Hao and Chuan. Is going to be enough damage though? Hao still alive, gets the Omni Slash onto Envy, and Envy, the first to fall as Newbie, forcing Secret back. So only four of Secret getting themselves out of there. Envy will drop, and Newbie have the position to find another tier 1 from this bottom lane by the looks of it. A Secret are going to have a hard time defending with all their ults expended.
Now, they were kind of lacking damage there. Like, the Roar comes out, but there's spin, so there's not really like any arrow or Starstorm that's going to follow it up. And even with the Chrono and the Air Splitter on top of it, Hao was just too tanky during that. You had KP on the back line disrupting the other heroes, getting the Vendetta and the stun off, and the damage output of Newbie right now is just way higher than Secret. Like, a Secret scale probably a little bit better with the items, but if they can't fight around all of their abilities landing perfectly in a team fight, they probably don't even do enough damage to get a kill, which is the biggest struggle of their lineup right now. And with that, RTZ is buying a Vlad, so I'm guessing he's going for the Defusal Manta build after this. Because right now, there's no book.
Oh, Envy. He had a painful day yesterday. This is looking to be the start of another painful one as KP, Hao, and Chuan catch the Razor out. No help for Envy as he's out all alone on the top lane. No tier 1 or anything for backup to come from. And Envy falls for a second time in the last couple of minutes. Newbie lead 5-1. 13 and a half minutes in. It's certainly looking to be Newbie coming out on top of this early game.
I mean, this is the lineup that they drafted, right? They need to be winning this stage in the game. Like, you don't pick on dying and Nyx Timbersaw to not, you know, go fight heroes. So going the Boots of Travel build on the Razor and teleporting from lane to lane, hoping that Vendetta is not going to be up cooldown and farming in front of a tier 1 is very difficult to do. And I think to a degree, Nyx is just really good against Secret in general because of the style of their cores. Like, Artor and Envy both like to farm a lot. So if they're off on their own in side lanes doing whatever and you're playing against a Nyx, it's just very easy for you to get picked off in that situation. Like, maybe the Void can get away. But when you send that many heroes, like I think it was 3 or 4 Anubi who went up there to gank the Razor, you're gonna die. Like, there's no chance that you can live through that.
Seeing the mid lane Moot. Making sure the puppy doesn't get too comfortable looking for the levels and experience and farm in that mid lane. At the same time, bottom Secret grouped up as 3. They'll finish off a tier 2. Arteezy takes the final touch. He's just about 500 gold behind Howe's net worth. It's still relatively close between the two of them. Howe looking to keep that lead though as he puts some pressure on the tier 2 top. KP backing around behind him under the cover of smoke and Vendetta, just in case a reaction comes out from Secret. As Newbie do have 4 up here, ready to fight. Secret at the moment more interested in potentially looking to push down the tier 1 mid or into the jungle though. Puppy comes, KP is gonna not catch the stun, and Puppy under the cover of Moonlight will be fine as Newbie unable to touch him out even more. RTZ is actually gonna try and use this Moonlight to potentially set something up as he moves in. Has a Chronosphere available, Kaka hiding in the trees. RTZ is gonna waltz past him. But straight back towards the tier 2, Newbie with the full team around.
It shouldn't take a fight without Sam. He just teleported back to base. He has his book 1. But if Secret try to fight this, I don't think they have any chance of winning unless the Beastmaster is actually there. For now, it just seems that they're trying to split up the map as best they can. They actually knew where the Nyx was for the first time in a little while, so that gives them a bit more breathing room and feel safe about doing the split pushing thing. Like, we can see Envy here is just farming up the woods. But yeah, they need everyone if they're going to fight.
And with this base, Howe finds tier 2 top, just about 600 away from Battle Fury's completion. Phase Boots and Yasha, so still very, very fast farm for Howe. 7.5k, 16 minutes in. I see a scan from Raiden. It did catch Secret moving across. KP, they get eyes onto Pylite die. We'll see himself if he wants to go for a bit of a solo kill potentially. He might just be lacking a bit on the damage. And Ode Pai throws out an arrow. Secret they do have here is a round pole, but MV moving in, looking for Kaka, dropping the roar, taking down the Undying. Get themselves a freebie. A sentry is placed, but KP's already on his way out. Secret get a nice arrow connection from Pai, take the kill, and Newbie not in a position to fight back.
It just goes to show that Secret understand their weakness of, we need to throw everything at one hero to kill it. It's like, we need to roar, we need to just make sure we hit an arrow, just all the kitchen sink. Doesn't matter. If one hero from Newbie is dead, there is a lot less likelihood that somebody's going to be getting ganked in a side lane. I think it's definitely the right approach right now if you're Secret. You want to make sure that you're getting those kills, getting the map control, taking it to a later stage in the game. Like, try to delay as much as possible.
This is going to be that point as well where Newbie and Moo more specifically has the chance to snowball out of control or get knocked back down. Bloodstone is finished. We'll see if he's able to start to rack up the charges. I haven't really seen too much, too many kills so far, as both teams have been trying to play as safely as possible. It's pretty much mainly been KP able to kick stuff off. The Nyx Assassin getting the lock onto here as a Secret, as we can see. 4 assists out of the 5 kills so far down to this Nyx Assassin and his initiations.
It's a very similar feeling yesterday when we saw Secret play against Eholm.
Yeah.
And the Nyx of Eholm just completely dismantled them. It seems like they're not struggling as much as they were in that game, but you can definitely tell that Newbie has the map control advantage. Their cores are farming a little bit more than Secret. The Battle Fury with the Yasha is done on Howe, so his farm is going to start to accelerate even more. Whereas the Void, he went for the Yasha and the Vlad's build. He's trying to make himself relevant as fast as possible, but also make sure that he can still farm a bit. It's like a hybrid build going for like Manta Defusal with the Vlad's. Because you still do a ton of damage when you get all the items, but you need at least one thing that's going to allow you to stay out on the map and be more efficient, and that's kind of why the Vlad's is necessary in this situation. Also, it's just a nice pairing with Beastmaster. Having the inner Beast plus Vlad's gives you a lot of damage and survivability inside of the fights.
Secret bringing Envy over to the bottom lane. There's going to be a smoke up from Bulber and Pai. See if they want to go deep into the jungle of Newbie, try and find themselves a pick. Puppy, ready to go in as well, picks himself up dust, making sure there's not a chance that they get caught out by the Nyx Assassin. Ready to pop it if their smoke does get dispelled by the invisible hero. But as we can see, Newbie again, they just seem to be aware of Secret's plans, how immediately TP's away from the bottom lane. The rest of Newbie have moved back towards mid. Secret, the smoke runs out. They're unable to find anything. Are going to continue to move over to the mid lane. The ward's down. Newbie are well aware of Secret's movement, and they will be there to react if Pi goes in. Pi coming across the mid lane. That was close. He waltzes his back out. We can see KP playing around with the idea of going in on Bulba, but the sentry's there. Bulba does have Roar, and Arteezy in the neighborhood if KP comes back in range. Maybe they could try and go for something here. But at the same time, Newbie, they're just trying to use the map to their best. How? A moment hanging around Kaka and Chuan. Just pick up the side camp. Top lane's pretty much free reign for Mu on the Timberstore. Chuan gonna toy with Pi Light High a little bit. Actually dropping the Demonic Purge. Pi forced to just TP straight back to base. But again, neither team finding the opening that they wish to work with.
KP was so close to getting killed there. And the funny part was, he walked into Sentry for a second, but obviously you don't want to just casually walk straight down into the Nyx and try to roar him, because he's in Vendetta, so he's going to be running faster than you. And he was trying to walk down as if he was going to kill the or the small camp and go to the right, but KP still backed off, even just not knowing if the Sentry was down.
Okie dokie, KP grabs an ED, but they had the Sentry down. Secret ready for the Nyx Assassin.
That's big. That is so big. Beastmaster
absolutely.
And Vlad, this is free Roche.
Opening up the Roshan pit. Newbie, they are. Are they going to try anything for this? They're down an Nyx Assassin. Secret, actually, they want to find themselves another pick by the looks of it before going for the Roche attempt. They headed towards me, but the TP out was already there. But they don't find anyone. Secret. Oh, now with this time that they spent moving away from Roche, there's going to be the full five man of Newbie back up, and Secret looks like they're not confident enough to try for Roshan at this time, feeling that it could still be a little risky against Newbie's lineup.
I'm really surprised that they actually didn't go for that. I felt like that was a really big opening for them, and I'm pretty sure they had vision of at least one or two Newbie heroes at the time where they killed the Nyx. Maybe they felt like without having Chrono it was just too risky, but they still had Roar and they still had Necro Book as well. So I think those two things alone are enough to turn the fight. Because you can put the book on the Timber, you just mana burn him, or you know, you put it on the Shadow Demon, and Shadow Demon just dies to a book three because it's a Shadow Demon. I feel like Secret maybe underestimating their position in this game, or just respecting Newbie.
One lane Newbie, ready to group and go. KP, of course, has just picked up the Blink Dagger. He lined himself in the tree line, see if he's able to get a bite, as Secret may move out. Envy at the moment. The lone man standing with Pylab die right beside him. The rest of Secret not here on the bottom, but Newbie themselves back away. In terms of Roche potential, I guess Newbie, they can't really do it that quick themselves. So are we unlikely to see the Radiant try for a Roche attempt, at least with when Secret's still on the map as a five man?
I don't think so. Secret have Chrono and Elder Titan with the Beastmaster. It's like going into the pit when all of Secret are alive is ill-advised. That is for sure. But it's not that their team is bad at killing Roche, it just takes a little bit longer. With Healing Ward, they should be more than okay. I mean, Timber can tank it up too, just in case. It's very easy to stay at a high amount of health as a newbie. Now, this game is a lot of movement. Both teams trying to just vie for whatever map control they can get. It's hard though for newbie because they are playing against a Beastmaster now who has a book 3. And when that happens, you're in a situation where as Nyx, your game suddenly becomes super difficult. Granted, he does have Blink, so that's going to help in some regards of getting KP actually into the fight when he sees an opening. But just getting a pick is becoming increasingly difficult.
Maybe again, they're going to try for a play here. The smoke on the mid lane. Secret are all grouped up as a five, so we'll see what kind of opening newbie can find and how quickly they can react. They've got the eyes onto Arteezy, looking to set up KP, allowing Howe to get in with the Omni Slash, and Arteezy taken down. Secret. They have Puppy hold by the rest of Newbie with a stomp. Arrow's not going to get in as the zombie is actually blocking the arrow. So Newbie finds a pick and Secret, the man down, unable to fight back into it. Puppy's got to deal with the zombies. The rest of Newbie head towards the mid lane. They've got their eyes onto a tier 2 as they look to take another objective. Fortification comes out from Secret. Puppy's just going to try and do his best with the spirit to slow down Newbie's aggression. 20 seconds before Artur's back. We'll have the Chronos to the Sphere, of course, at the ready when he's back in the game. They're going to be before Newbie are able to finish off The tier 2 tower in the mid lane. Oh, KP jumps in. It's the stun. Immediately Mook gets the damage down. Envy pops the BKB, but the demonic purge from Tron fighting him up. Envy can't quite close the gap in onto any of the members of Newbie. And they'll find themselves the tower. They force a BKB charge out from Envy, and they get out scot-free once again.
That was a really nice jump from the Nyx. Getting that bonus kill, making sure the tier 2 is going to go down. Elder Titan's the best hero at delaying any push and also delaying Roche if you were going to go for it. So he's a high priority target, even in the support position. Thought for a minute that Artur might decide to buy back just because Roshan's always on the table, but after realizing that you have Elder Titan and Beastmaster Vision, I don't think Newbie would have ever gone for that.
Ulbran Envy. Gotta be careful here. Newbie hot on the trail. Indeed, will leave the jungle, and they're actually going to head into Roshan. Envy and Arteezy starting to go to work. He's back up and heading his way over, so Secret will have the full team ready for this attempt. Yubi, they're going to have something to say about it, though. On the high ground, decking in the poison. At the moment, top is Mu on the timber, putting the pressure on the top lane. Now he'll bots over to the bottom. Roshan down to less than half health. Yubi. They can't stop Secret from doing this. Secret are going to have a nice little leg up, and here we have the jump in, Mu. Spooking Artur. Secret back up. KP's going to miss the stun. Secret can't find the access to go back in onto him, but they'll go into Mu instead. Roar into nice static link. They'll start to steal the damage. A disruption trying to hold back. The advance is not going to occur here, and Kaka with the zombie tombstone down is making Secret back off. The zombie's stacking up. All right. The Moonlight and Envy trying to go for this one. BKB takes down Tron. Demonic Purge gonna stop him from being able to do anything more. Arteezy coming across, still has the Chronosphere at the ready. Does he want to try and go for a jump? He will, goes in, hits the two-man Chrono, but he himself getting stunned up by KP. They'll look to Hao, but Hao incredibly tanky at this point, and he just walks off, jumps back in fact, looking for the Omni Sash, but the damage is not quite enough. Can he finish up Pi with a Blade Fury? He can. Arteezy needs to be careful now himself. Time walks up. They've lost Pi. Secret on the retreat. KP blinks forward. Can't quite close the gap onto Envy. Mu might be able to. Now the Shrakgrim's just a little bit short. But that's at least Newbie for Secret away from the Roshan pit. How? He's going to jump straight back in and look to finish this one off and take it away from Team Secret.
The fights are so hard to win for Secret when they don't have Book. Like, the whole problem is that if Necro is dead, you can't fight.
Secret, they are still wanting to try and do something about this. Envy coming across. Static Link's going to be broken immediately by Blink out from KP. Envy pokes the ult, trying to go in. Arteezy looking for the ceiling. Oh, he gets the kill! Arteezy takes the Roche kill, gets the Aegis. Is he going to be able to get himself out alive? No. They'll take the Aegis straight back out of the hands of Artur, but he took it away from Newbie. He is going to pay with his life. But a little bit of a silver lining there for Secret as Artur is able to take away Roche and take away the Aegis out of the hands of the Chinese.
Give that man a purple heart. He gets the last hit and he gets the Aegis. Wow, that was insane. I mean, they're doing such a good job at delaying Newbie from hitting their full stride, but it feels like the lineup just hasn't quite come to fruition yet. They're having serious damage output problems. It's just too difficult for them to line up all of their spells in conjunction. The Nyx, like KP, he pops Spike Carapace, he gets in there. If Puppy tries to stomp, you can just walk into the Spirit with Carapace on, and you just stop the Elder Titan from casting his spell. Like, there's so many different ways that the Nyx can screw with the Elder Titan in this game that, you know, Puppy's having a very hard time with it. The other part too, and we're gonna get to see it here.
Absolutely.
This is just like,
so you got Hao beating down. Arteezy comes in, gives it one hit, and bam, he's got it. Aegis in the hands. Of course, he does end up going down twice, and Newbie, of course, still with a very sizable lead this game. But little things like that are what's gonna keep Secret in this. They certainly need a quite a bit more before they're able to swing it back around into their favor. As Hao continues to get out of control, as expected, we said at the start, he was getting a free lane, having an easy start, and the games pretty much continued at that pace for him. He's 3-1-4, 17,000 net worth at the 28-minute mark. Mu, of course, he's continued to have a great game, or and post Bloodstone pickup, 16 charges, Blink Dagger, Yule's bots, Plate Mail as well in tow. This is one scary, scary Timbersaw. As the game goes on, 28 minutes in, 9-4.
The way that Newbie are itemizing and the heroes that they have, because of the Blink Battle Fury on Hao, because it's a Timbersaw, they're able to just shove out the waves so effectively and just farm so much faster than what Seeker can get. Like, you're farming against a Razor, not really a hero known for being able to maintain a high level of CS per minute. Void is more or less the same thing unless you're going for either a Battle Fury or a Maelstrom. So Newbie are winning these fights, they're shoving the lanes, and they're not allowing Secret to really get enough out of the map to make some kind of comeback. It's really going to be reliant on that big wombo combo. And I find myself often saying this when I watch this combination of heroes now, is that it almost becomes 100% reliant on that to happen in order for the other team to win. And that's not really a good thing. You don't want to put so much pressure on your heroes to say, okay, you need to hit a 3 or 4 man Chrono. You need to hit a 3 or 4 man Earth Splitter. But that really is what it feels like needs to happen for Secret to turn an engagement.
Okay, Pete. They're just playing around at the bottom lane with moves. They had eyes onto Pi. Secret moving as a 4 man through their own jungle. At the moment now, starting to band a little bit more together to create space for Envy. Keep the farm going on the Razor. He's nearly about to hit level 16. He's on top with TZ in terms of Secret's net worth, but of course there is still that massive gap between them and the cause of Newbie. Newbie actually heading up round behind Secret. We'll see if they find an opening to make a go. The ward down. They are going to see the movement. KP's going to be the one to lead in, but Paul, but they've got the vision down. A Meteor Roar now take down the Nyx Assassin. Splitter to connect onto anyone. Secret at least forcing Newbie to be a bit careful about moving in for more. Secret one kill up at the moment in this fight, and it looks like that will be all.
You can see how confident Newbie are. When that hero died, they were walking forward. They weren't running away. They say, yeah, we have a huge advantage in regards to net worth. You killed our Nyx. Nyx is like 5k net worth. No one really cares if that hero dies. Sorry, KP. You've been playing a great game, but if you're dead, it doesn't matter. Like Newbie can just still run at you. Because of the fact that they have to throw so many spells into like an offlane slash support capacity Nyx to get the kill, it just means that Newbie know they can win the fight even if it's a 4v5.
That's no surprise as well. I mean, if you just look at the network, probably without the Nyx Assassin there, there's still a lead for Newbie. Yeah. So the maths don't lie.
Yeah, even with Nyx being dead, Newbie still have an advantage. Oh dear. That being said, Secret have the ability to delay the game very well with their heroes. They often pick these types of lineups that are just super good at defending high ground. I mean, we casted a 61-minute game at them yesterday.
Out of time.
Yeah, and they just sat there and held and held and held for what seemed like 30-plus minutes at least. I don't know if Newbie are going to take the same amount of time to crack that high ground, but the later the game goes, the Juggernaut, he will get to a point where his inventory is going to be full. And once that happens, yeah, the Void's going to start to get more powerful. You're going to see Aghanim's, you know, just finished here up on Pilei Dai. It's going to start helping out here.
See, looking at RTZ, he'll time walk away. Pops the Chrono with the Omni Slash as Hal rides Artur out of the Chronosphere. And at the same time, move. He's able to clean up a puppy kill. Before it all went down, they did lose KP down bottom. But as we said, we're sorry, KP. But your life is worth a lot less than those two of Secret's.
My God,
at this stage, Newbie very happy with these trades, and how he's a bit of a ninja.
That was nasty. That was straight up nasty. I mean, it was almost so close with the timing of the Chrono that it might have not even been 100% intentional. Still, it looked really freaking cool.
Now, he's going to find himself straight up with Envy. Envy pops the BKB, has to back up immediately. And Hal just turns his attention back towards the tier 3 fortification coming out from Secret. They'll have RTZ back in 10, but no Chrono. Pi actually jumping forward here. Mu jumps back onto him with Hal, and Pi! That was not the lead you were looking for. Newbie takes the kill, takes the tower, and now with KP stun, moving for more. Puppy is down. It's a double kill for Mu. There'll be a roar from Bulba. Envy stealing a fair bit of damage. Artur now jumping back in to force them back. Hal able to blink away thanks to the save from the defensive destruction of Chuan. The stun from KP forcing Artur to time walk back. Newbie still hanging around right outside the door of Secret's base. They're 2 man down for 20 seconds. Chuan. There's disruption. KP with the follow-up. Stun it again. The control is beautiful from Newbie. Perfect execution. RTZ down for a full minute. Newbie, they're going to be able to find the window to finish off the racks in the mid lane. 50 seconds with no Void on the defense. We'll see how much Secret lose here. As newbie may stick around for more. KP is jumping in.
He wants that stun.
He just teases. And Secret trying to hold with the four man. But as we see just every time, newbie so good at jumping in on this. The tombstone down and how? In with the Omni Slash Puppy. Ripped to shreds. Envy's in trouble as well as KP hits the stun. It's a godlike streak for Mood. Three dead on Secret. And newbie will now look to take a second set of racks. Pi, better get yourself back to base, son. As newbie 16 for 6 at this stage, it could all be over for Secret here in game one. They need something miraculous. RTZ will be back on the void. Chrono at the ready. They need Puppy. They need his Earth Spitter. It's already been used. Finds the raw move, maybe overextending a little bit too much. The follow up arrow, they'll get the big kill onto the timber. But the rack stop are already gone. And newbie say, you could take the timber saw. We've just taken your hopes and dreams, and we've crushed them in our palms. As two sets of racks down on the side of Secret. Need to find more. They need to punish newbie harder. Maybe with a movement onto Kaka, they can. Out of mana. But how just jumps in, cleans out the army. So there's no follow up damage from Secret there. And newbie looking to jump in again. The setup into the stun onto RTZ. The stun from Puppy will allow Artur to get the chance to time warp back. But how jumping in? He's looking for blood, looking for kills. He'll take a dog. The 16 for 7 has just amped up the pace of this game, and Secret seeming unable to deal with newbie's aggression. And just look at these net worths getting absolutely out of control. 25k now on Hao, 20k on Moot. Secret needs something miraculous.
Yeah, they need a miracle for sure. I mean, they can throw out a Chrono, put the Earth Splitter in there, hope for the best. The Aurora is going to be back up in about 5 seconds on the Beastmaster, but this is definitely the last hurrah. Getting a kill on the cores of newbie right now requires such heavy commitment. You need to throw everything at them.
And this needs to be the fight, the best fight that Secret have had over the last 2 days if they wish to bring themselves back into this one. They'll find the Ron to move. RTZ jumps forward. He has got a Chrono. He's going to catch Tron and move. They need the follow-up damage. Pi coming in with a star.
Omni.
But Omni from Isle rips forward to pieces. Envy, he's trying to get himself out with the BKB, but it can't escape. Two dead. Envy's being surrounded by newbie. They've lost the third. Secret Pi jumps in as a final run, and indeed it is that, the final one. GG is called. Secret will lose yet another game here in quick succession in these group stages. And newbie will find the first of this series with a very, very convincing performance, and a performance the Secret were just unable to knock.
You know, in the laning phase, it seemed everything was more or less going according